Hi, welcome today to and Melanie's journey. I'm Kayla.
I'm Melanie, and we are here today with Sophia Crawford, aka Miss Pink.
Hello.
So, tell us a little bit about yourself. You know, did you accomplish where you're from? You know.
Well, I'm from London, England. I was born in England and spent most of my childhood and teenage years in England growing up. But then when I was about 18, 19, I travelled quite extensively, backpacking across Europe, and ended up in India. And from there, I went to Thailand, and I lived in Thailand for about a year and a half. And it was in Thailand that I discovered the film industry. And I was working in a hotel teaching English to the staff of the hotel called the Central Plaza Hotel. And they asked me if I could do a brochure for them, just, you know, advertising the hotel. I did the brochure and the casting people signed me up and asked me if I was interested in doing extra work. And I didn't even really, you know, I'd never thought about going into film at all. And even at that time, I hadn't trained in martial arts yet. I was a tomboy in school, you know. I was just one of the kids. I grew up in the countryside and we, you know, we played out in the fields. We played on the hay bales. And I played with the boys a lot. I was a rough girl.
That was me.
Right, right. And it was so much fun, but I hadn't, you know, I guess what I'm trying to say is in my teenage years, it wasn't like I'm going to be a stunt woman, I'm going to be an actress. I had no clue what to do. So my attempt of, you know, the idea of traveling was for me in the hope that I would maybe along the way come up with a plan, right? Yeah. But what happened was, so then I got this job in Thailand, and my first film that I worked on as an extra was Around the World in 80 Days and Kickboxer with John Colvin from Van Gogh, right? So, and you know, in these films it was a Hong Kong camera, mostly production guys, and they all talked about Hong Kong, saying, oh, if you want to get into the film industry, you should go to Hong Kong. And so I did. I traveled to Hong Kong and I auditioned for a movie and I got the part. And pretty much basically from then on out, I spent the next 5 years training with stuntmen, stuntwomen, learning martial arts and learning stunts and acting.
Yeah. I feel like a lot of young people like feel like they need to know what they want to do.
There's pressure. Sometimes there's a lot of pressure on people to, okay, what do you want to do? You're 6 years old and you're like, yeah, what? I don't know. I mean, you know, everybody's different. Some people automatically, they grow up and they know exactly what they want to do. They're inspired at a very young age, whether it's through their parents, their families, because I have a lot of stunt friends, you know, that have children and their children evolve and they grow up and they go into the stunt business, often very young and very early.
Yeah.
And that's what they want to do. But my father was an economist. Mm-hmm. My mother died when I was very young. So there wasn't, it really, I'm like, where do I go? What do I do? So it was really a journey for me, very much of trying to discover what I wanted and what was my passion.
Yeah.
And the minute I started practicing martial arts, it was like, this is it. I don't care if I'm on camera or not on camera. You know, this is it.
It's the love.
The love, the absolute love for it, yeah.
Really?
Yeah, just the movement, the artistic nature of it, the challenge of it, yes, the competitiveness of it, I mean, all of it, you know? So Hong Kong for 5 years before I came here.
That's cool. That's awesome.
Thank you.
That's a better story than when I started.
Yeah, I mean, you know, a lot of people, I traveled on the bus, you know, from London, and we drove through 12 different countries, and it wasn't a luxurious trip. This was a backpacking trip. You slept in tents, you went to the villages during the day, it was all off the beaten track. You bought your food in the villages and you cooked it at night on a campfire.
Yeah.
You know, and 15 people started this bus trip and only 8 of us finished it.
Wow.
Because it was hardcore.
Yeah.
It was hardcore, but probably, I would say, one of the best experiences of my entire life.
Yeah, because normally people do like the tourists.
No, this was all...
Not Sophia. All
right, so next question. What was it like when you actually started martial arts, like getting into it? Like, how did you notice it at first?
How did I notice it? In like, what regard?
Recognize it, like how did it...
That it was a good fit for me?
Yeah.
Or, you know who inspired me so much in Hong Kong? And I don't know if you know her, you might look her up, but she was an action star in Hong Kong, and later she actually became my mentor. Her name was Yukari Oshima. She came from Japan Action Club. She was stuck on in there, but she was a very successful actress in Hong Kong. What inspired me about her was her intensity. Yeah. She was one of these fighters that had so much intensity when she fought and very clean skills.
Mm-hmm.
And I looked at her, set her focus, and I thought, wow, you're so strong but so calm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I was like, wow, I want to be like that. That really. And so, because anytime you learn martial arts in the beginning, you're frantic, you're confused, you feel like a failure, I'm not as good as this person, that person's better than me. And you start comparing yourself and you go through all these processes. And then I think later on, as you start learning, and you become a little bit more intuitive to what fits you.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's what I love about martial arts, is that there are so many different disciplines. So perhaps if wushu is not right for you, then perhaps kickboxing is right for you, or another discipline might be right for you. And then you mix them up and you take bits from each discipline that fit you, and you create something that fits you. You know?
Yeah.
And I always felt that about myself. I always felt like, well, I'm not going to be, I'm not going to be great with wushu, I'm not going to be great with that, but what I really like is this style. And so I took up Taekwondo because I really like the style, I love the look of it, and it was also a good fit for film, because with Taekwondo, you got such pretty extension on your kicks, lots of jump kicks, beautiful, you know, to watch, and very cinematic.
So how did you get to audition to be the Pink Ranger, how did that come about?
What happened with that was my now husband, Jeff Burt, he was a stunt coordinator on the show. We had actually worked together on a low budget film called Sword Mono. We had played brother and sister. And he had been watching my Hong Kong movies for years and knew who I was, but didn't think that I would be interested. He thought I was only interested in acting. But when he met me and he realized, I was like, wow, I mean, you want to give me a stunt double job? I like stunts, period. I don't care if I'm acting, I don't care if you see my face or don't see my face. Just want to do the action, you know. It's like, so then when he got Power Rangers, he remembered me and brought me in for an audition, and I just auditioned just like everybody else, you know. But I think what really, really helped me on the audition was because Hong Kong action is so animated, if you know what I mean. That the movements that were required for Power Rangers.
Yeah.
It fit perfectly with what I'd already kind of practiced and experienced in Hong Kong.
Yeah.
So it really, even though at the time in Hong Kong I didn't realize how that training would help me so much in the US, mm-hmm. but if I had never gone to Hong Kong, I never would have had a chance in the US. Yeah. It really gave me a lot of preparation and experience. Yeah. So,
are there a lot of people who?
Yeah, well, lots of people, amazing martial artists, you know. I'm like, you want me? Freaking crazy.
Is that how you met your husband?
No, I mean, we worked together on the movie, and I met him, you know, at a screening prior. And also Richard Brandon threw my name in as well for the audition. There were a few people in the circuit there that threw my name in. The thing about the industry here in the martial arts industry, stunt industry, it's a tight community. Everybody knows each other. And so, you know, if you hear of a job or something coming up, usually somebody will recommend you or throw your name in so you can at least go and audition, you know. And I just auditioned just like everybody else. Jeff said yay. I went in there, worked on the show for about a year, did the first movie in Sydney.
Oh yeah, people know that.
Oh, it was a great experience. That was really wonderful. But the Power Rangers when I was on the show, even when Jeff was on the show, the first season, it really wasn't the big hit until second season.
Yeah.
You know, and then all of a sudden we were shooting like right here at Lake Castaic, and when the show started to become more popular, you know, people started coming to the lake to watch us shooting. Yeah. So then we had to start having security, and then we had to start having, you know.
You didn't think it was going to be that big.
No, not at all. I mean, you just don't, especially with something like that. I mean, I was like, oh my God, this is so childish, but it's for kids. Come on, it's for kids.
Yeah.
But it took off like a riot, and I think it's partly because just the colorful, you know, nature, the nature of the characters. Yeah. It was fantasy and a lot of fun for children. But you know, one of the things on Power Rangers was that we weren't allowed to do any head kicks.
Good.
Did you know that?
I think I've noticed that.
Fun fact, there was never head kicks in Power Rangers.
We can do head kicks. We have to kick to the body.
Yeah. I remember you guys.
Now you guys know.
Body. But I don't remember.
If you had hit the head, it would have to be in a fun sort of way. You'd have to.
Or like
to
kind of miss.
Yeah, you know, yeah. It might have to be more like, yeah.
Like show.
Just, yeah. So it wasn't so aggressive, it wasn't so, because.
I wanted, like not to, yeah.
Parents were worried about the violence aspect, you know, and, you know, as kids, you watch upright martial arts shows, you kind of, you want to go out in the backyard and start to square off, right?
Yeah.
So they felt that if we had too many head kicks and stuff like that, would be a bad influence on the children. So any time Jeff worked out the choreography, it was always done in a very fun, comedic fashion.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. I didn't even know about that. Yeah. But I did. I noticed it now that I look at it.
Yeah, I noticed it now. But
now that you look at it, you can probably see what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
That was fun. It was just
go back and look over it.
Yeah.
We'll have one more question.
Okay.
Was it hard getting gigs as a woman, or?
Yes.
Like, as a woman, was it
harder
to get? Because like some people say, most men are getting this done.
Well, it's actually interesting because things have changed a bit now. We're talking about 20 years ago, when the thing was is there was no opportunity. There was lack of opportunity because the scripts weren't written for the women to have those kind of roles, you know. Generally speaking, back then the type of roles you were given would be the girlfriend of the bad guy, you know, or the victim. But there weren't any really strong female driven roles, you know, very, very few. And even when we were trying to pitch stuff back in the day, you know, producers would say that, or the money people would say that, you know, a female actually doesn't sell, you know, and They didn't believe that it would sell to an audience. But having said that, the roles that really propelled my career were strong female roles. So you look at Power Rangers, Buffy the Vampire Slayer.
Buffy too.
So here you are, here was a very strong female character.
Yeah,
you know, right? And so nowadays you're seeing a lot more opportunity for women. And you have a lot more women training in martial arts since the, you know, huge success of MMA.
Mm-hmm.
You know, more women are inspired to take up martial arts, whether it's for, you know, professional fighting, self-defense, or whether it's for the films, you know. So there's more opportunity now than there used to be, which I'm really, really happy about, and I love to see it because, you know, I mean, I absolutely support the women and that are out there playing these roles, and I wish there were more of them. But there are now than there ever used to be. It was much more challenging back then, much, much more. You know, upsetting in some regard, because you get a role in a movie and then all of a sudden you're just holding this guy's hand and then maybe, you know, I remember doing a fight once where the guy's saying, I'm not going to hit you because you're a girl, and then so therefore my fight got cut down to nothing and all I got was one hit and I'm down on the ground, and then you just kind of sit there and go, really?
You're like, what?
I mean, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want some more, like?
Well, just give the girls some. It was like intelligence, intelligence, courage, power. You know, don't just have us stand aside and watch and run away or whatever.
Yeah.
You know. Girls are fun to watch fighting too.
Yeah. We kick butt too.
Exactly. We kick butt too.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Alrighty, well I think that concludes our interview. Thank you very much for
I'm gonna miss you. Can I just give you a hug?
Sophia is my personal trainer, so.
Yeah. She worked us out today.
Yeah. She worked us arms.
I did.
But okay. That concludes the end of our video. Please subscribe down below. Hit that up with a big thumbs up. And follow all our social media.
And soon we'll have links to our funding pages. So go down there and help us out. Yeah. We'll go travel, see the world, get us experience. Thanks a lot.
All right, see you guys.
Show some support for these girls.